have taught the Obama administration anything, it is caution about getting in bed with companies that flout the rules, especially those who do so with deadly results. And so in our fourth story tonight, the Obama administration in just the past week has awarded contracts worth nearly $250 million to the company formerly known as Blackwater. We told you Monday about the first $120 million of it, the State Department paying XE, Blackwater's new name, to guard new U.S. consulates in Afghanistan. The Washington Post reporting today that the CIA just tossed Z another $100 million to guard its facilities in Afghanistan, and you don't want to know about its facilities in Afghanistan and elsewhere around the world. On Monday, the State Department testified that Z got the contract because other contractors were not qualified and said, yes, the State Department did take into account Z's past performance, including the 2007 massacre of 17 Iraqi civilians by Z mercenaries, one of whom has pleaded guilty, five others still being pursued by prosecutors. Z, nay Blackwater, says it has cleaned up its act. One senior VP testifying in February that Z's, quote, changes in personnel, attitude, focus, policy and practice, ownership and governance represent a break from the past to a culture of compliance that in all circumstances reflects a responsible U.S. government contractor. An unnamed U.S. official familiar with the CIA deal told the Post, quote, Blackwater has undergone some serious changes. They've had to prove to the government that they're a responsible outfit. 2008, hundreds of automatic weapons meant for Afghanistan police signed out for impermissible personal use by a Blackwater mercenary who signed his name, Eric Cartman. January 7th of this year, Z mercenaries indicted for murdering Afghan civilians last year. March of this year, Senate Armed Services Committee reveals Z used a shell company to win other contracts in Afghanistan and made false statements to do so. April 16th of this year, five top Z officers indicted on weapons charges. Does Z's owner, Eric Prince, the founder of Blackwater, think that Z has changed its ways? Less than 2 months after his top officers were indicted, Prince put his company up for sale. On CNBC this morning, he made it sound as though his company is just fine the way it's always been. It's the critics who are the problem.
At the end of the day, after 3.5 years of an assault by some of the bureaucracy, kind of a proctology exam brought on by some in Congress, it's time to hang it up, because I think some in Washington view politics a lot more important than performance in the field.
With us tonight, in this case, head of proctology, Jeremy Scahill, national security reporter for The Nation magazine, author of Blackwater, The Rise of the World's Most Powerful Mercenary Army. It's good to see you again, Jeremy.
Thanks for having me.
So the CIA is hiring Z. Does Eric Prince have something on Leon Panetta or somebody in the agency? Or how did this happen?
Well, you know, I don't think that he has his hands on a secret Leon Panetta sex tape or something. But what he does have is a 10-year record of participating in direct lethal actions, including the CIA assassination program, carrying out covert actions for the U.S. government around the world, many of which this administration doesn't want made public, the CIA doesn't want made public. And so Prince has been engaging in something called gray mail, where you essentially are nervous that they're going to come after you. So you basically say to them, I will show them where some of these bodies are buried, and I'll tell them who buried those bodies. So the Obama administration, I think, is playing a very high-stakes chess game right now with Blackwater.
That quote, the new senior VP, changes in personnel, attitude, focus, policy and practice, ownership and governance represent a break from the past to a culture of complaint. Is any of that true? Has they cleaned up the act at all?
Yeah, they've cleaned up their act about as much as BP has cleaned up the Gulf. I mean, if by clean up their act you mean they change their name and they put some new figureheads in charge of the company, yeah, their act is totally clean. But this is the same company whose top five deputies to Eric Prince, as you mentioned, were indicted on very serious charges. There are rumors that Prince himself may face some kind of indictment. And this is a company that continues to operate armed and dangerous, not just in Afghanistan, Keith. As we understand now, they're working for the CIA globally. So who knows what they're doing around the world right now on behalf of the U.S. government.
The Secretary of State, when she ran for the presidential nomination, opposed this kind of mercenary contracting. So did President Obama. We thought he did. What's going on relative to the leadership at the highest levels here?
Right. Well, I think that what this shows is that the United States has become entirely reliant upon these private sector forces. The fact is that we are now addicted as a nation to outsourcing national security policy. 70% of all personnel that work for the Department of Defense are now private contractors. I'm not just talking about the battlefield. I'm talking about the whole Department of Defense. So, you know, I've talked to a leading member of the Intelligence Committee today, Jan Schakowsky, who told me that she's repeatedly asked the Obama administration to justify this and has been given no clear reason for why they continue to do this.
If we're talking about covert ops, assassinations, other black bag jobs, and whatever else there is under the rocks, are there good companies that do this? I mean, is it an academic discussion of who's a good murder-for-hire operation and a bad murder-for-hire operation?
Well, I mean, if you review all of the companies and determine that Blackwater is your best company,
yes, okay,
then you know
point.
That this country is in serious, serious trouble with its national security policy.
You've reported Mr. Prince here, who is rumored to be looking to move. He's just outgrown the old place? Or?
Well, I've talked to people that are both involved with him personally and professionally at Blackwater who've said that he is planning on moving his family to the United Arab Emirates, which is, of course, in the Middle East and has become famous for housing war corporations. They also do not have an extradition treaty with the United States, so it would be a convenient place to relocate if you want to stay in the war business, service the corrupt monarchies of the Middle East, and avoid the U.S. law.
So we're putting them on TV, and I don't mean just CNBC, we're putting them on as an industry, we're putting them on TV to encourage people to invest or buy his plane ticket.
I mean,
for
I know this is your sister network here.
Yeah, I'm not
Keith,
criticizing them, but just generally
well,
speaking.
Well, I will. I mean, how can you have this guy on and not confront him with all that he's been alleged to have been involved with? I mean, I think we have to have some journalistic integrity. If we're going to have a man like Eric Prince sitting there who's responsible for so much death and destruction in our name, ask him some real questions.
Jeremy Scahill, the author of Blackwater, The Rise of the World's Most Powerful Mercenary Army, who has asked a lot of questions of these people over the years. And thank you for doing that, and thank you for coming in.
Thank